What sort of editing do you want? What if it's open source? What if it's ShotCut or VSDC? Having confusions? Stick till the end. Hey guys, what's up? This is RU with a completely new series. In this series, we're gonna talk about some basic editing softwares and then compare and differentiate between them. I hope all of you guys like it, and today we are gonna start with two open source softwares, these being ShotCut and VSDC Video Editor. So stick till the end, and if you have trouble hearing me, please focus on the subtitles, because English is not my first language, obviously. So yeah, after the intro, let's get straight to the video. So guys, the first one we're going to do is about the interface of both of these software. So just let's begin. So we are going to review them and then use those reviews as comparisons and differences. So at first, let's look at the interface. In one word, we can say that ShotCut is a friendly software and for which it has a friendly interface. Although it is harder than the simplest ones, it is pretty easy to use and quite, you know, simple. Now about the interface, as you can see in the screen right now, it's a pretty epic interface with a good display, tab, ribbons all around and a neat place for the timeline. I mean, whatever you need, you can just get it from the filters place and everything, like it's just in your hand, and there are so many ways to locate your stuff and locate your edits and stuff, so you know, ShotCut is really cool. Moreover, for the basic editing, by which I mean filters and all, and many stuff we're gonna talk about later, you can easily find them and then use them. Now let's go to VSDC Video Editor. Now I gotta say, if you're a rookie in video editing, I'd suggest you take a look at OpenShot or Windows Movie Maker or even ShotCut before this, and I wanna quote someone to explain this perfectly. So the quote is like this: "This is called free but professional editing skills," end quote. So VSDC is pretty good with editing, which we will come to in the next part, but for now let's look at the interface. Unlike ShotCut, it has already inbuilt tracks and the display tab is a bit bigger than that of ShotCut. And if you just look at this and then look at ShotCut, then you can definitely sense the difference and that how much advanced VSDC actually is. And it also has these properties windows and other color grading tabs and resolution stuff too. So yeah, the interface is like quite complex in ShotCut, but now the main question comes: who wins this interface round? Now according to me, I think ShotCut wins the interface round. Why? Because it's way much easier to locate stuff, you can learn most of the locations by yourself, and it's very easy. Note that we haven't got into editing yet, this is just the interface we were talking about. So yeah, just for the interface, I think ShotCut is the best. Now if you are a growing editor or even at beginning levels, ShotCut is the best for you and nothing can outstand it, at least among the free ones. However, when we compare ShotCut to other free editors, which in this case is VSDC Video Editor, ShotCut has its limitations. ShotCut limits its editing boundaries with the filters tab they use. However, it has the keyframes through which you can do basic green screen editing. The most useful ShotCut filters effective are the chroma keys, the text and the very useful video transitions, and pretty much that's what you need for a standard video. I personally like ShotCut a lot because it's very handy and easy to use. But keep this in mind, as I said before, ShotCut is applicable for only beginning levels of editing. It's an awesome software and probably the best for growing editors, but overall it isn't the best among all. So the basic things you need to know about ShotCut is it has these chroma keys, which are like really helpful for doing your intros, for doing your subscribe buttons, for getting any sort of thing. Like, you can don't just use ShotCut for your videos, you can also use ShotCut for any sort of editing you want and impress your family, your friends. And also ShotCut has this amazing text, the text fonts, which are also good in VSDC, but now we're talking about ShotCut. And according to the interface, all of the things are very easy to locate. You don't need any tutorials or something, and if you do need one, it'll take less time than to you know, learn about VSDC Video Editor. So it's very easy to locate stuff and then edit them, and ShotCut comparatively takes less time to edit the same thing you want to edit with VSDC Video Editor. And this is just a very important point I made, because as I said before, ShotCut is very easy to locate stuff in it and then edit it quickly. So that's what I think about the basic editing stuff. Next we will get to the edit filters, but before that, let's get to VSDC Video Editor. Yeah. As I said before, VSDC has a tough interface, so it's harder to locate stuff, for which the total time to edit takes longer than ShotCut. However, as the quote said before, it is a free but professional editor, which means that VSDC has more editing features than ShotCut. Among these, notable ones are animation, advanced color grading, crops and photo edits whilst being on a project, amazing transitions and the other stuff, but a bit advanced than ShotCut. The only thing I didn't like about VSDC is its interface, as it looks boring and definitely not user-friendly. However, if you have ambition to carry on editing on a huge scale, then I advise you to get to VSDC after you're done with beginning editors. VSDC is in a way pretty professional, and I heard loads of reviews saying it's better than paid programs like Camtasia and Filmora. Timelines on VSDC were perfect, with giving you the ability to create daughter clips and then use the edits over there to make it sync. With the original clip, also like ShotCut, it has multiple ways to edit the same stuff. Text, vid, video effects, chroma keys, and transitions, which are the most effective filters of ShotCut, are way much advanced in VSDC, as the properties window helps in the accuracy of green screen effects, as well as the diversity of text features. Color grading and video effects are on a next level in VSDC, which is really helpful, so in a way you can say that VSDC is really cool for professional editing. So according to the reviews, it's safe to say that VSDC wins this round of editing. And why? Of course, you know, because VSDC is like the advanced features, and it has more features than ShotCut, and the similar features which it and ShotCut has, VSDC seniors it, because you know it, the effects of VSDC are like really advanced. So that's why VSDC wins this overall editing round, and trust me, if it was just for the beginning levels, ShotCut would have won this round. Now guys, that we're done with the main interface and the editing, let's look at some small, you know, small details. So starting with the timeline of ShotCut. Now the ShotCut timeline, as you can see over here, is pretty simple. This might not seem pretty simple because I am in a video project in this one, but you know, the timeline is pretty simple in ShotCut. Like, you can add as many of the video and audio tracks as you want. You can insert track, remove track as per your wish. It's like really easy to locate this stuff. And then, you know, you have the open file button, open other button to easily like get some color and some transparent structure and stuff. And the other things I want to actually talk about is that it's really easy to add stuff. Like, if I want this, I can easily get it down over here to this video track, and you know, if I get the insert option, then I can just get it somewhere between them, which will just insert it, you know. So in a way, and this zoom thing button is like really cool, which actually increases the difference between the segments of your timeline. The playlist, the playhead thing is really cool. You don't need any type of accuracy. For example, I want my clip to be here, so if you just hover around this for a minute, it just automatically comes over here. Now if you want to drag it over here, it just automatically comes over here. So that's what I actually wanted to talk about today. Now guys, let's talk about the timeline of this. For example, I'm gonna take some project folders over here. So in one way, you can say that this is pretty much complex, and I don't think there is any way to like remove or anything. Like, you know, if I do that, the entire timeline gets removed. So you know, this is like a pretty complex for beginners compared to ShotCut, of course. And you know, if I add some more stuff, like if I do this, you need to do the rotate and scale option in ShotCut, but over here you can just do this. You can hover around. Now there is no zoom in, zoom out option in this. So for example, let's say that I want to add a song which is like 3 minutes long. So let's add this song. So as you can see, according to that song, this song is like 3 minutes long. So these two will be like for some seconds, right? So as you can actually see that they actually just adjust the timeline all by themselves. Now if I delete this, this gets back to normal. So that's another thing. And there are other things in ShotCut. For example, there are shortcuts, easy buttons, hotkeys and stuff, which are not that much available. Now I don't know anything else about VSDC, because I'm new to all this VSDC stuff, but still I don't think that there are any real types of shortcuts over here. So the timeline, I think ShotCut actually wins it. So guys, I think that was it. This was like a short video. I don't know how much long it went, but I tried to prove everything I wanted to prove in like a really short ways. And the reason I didn't put subtitles in the last, the small detail part is that it actually didn't need any subtitles. I will be doing some points in them so that you can just get the points which will like help you later on. So I really thank you, and if you could just subscribe, like the video and share this to the needy people, this will like help me a lot. If I get to 50 subscribers, I'll be really supportive.